what did I think my role would be? I didn't know. You know, there was a whole lot going on at that time, and but the environment was always important to me. In my very first race for office, and there have been a few, well, the campaign slogan, if you will, was the four E's: ethics, environment, education, and economy. And so the environment has always been a pivotal part of what I care about. I grew up here in St. Petersburg, Florida. It's a magnificent place. And the sheer beauty of it alone really drew my heart to appreciate the water and the environment that we enjoy as Floridians, and how that helps our economy, importantly, where the environment and the economy are inextricably linked to help Florida's job situation and people's future. So, you know, I realized as a new governor that, you know, your panacea is very wide, and there's a lot of things to deal with: education, crime, what have you. And the environment, though, is one of the pillars, as I mentioned earlier, going back. And so as I got more into the office and finished the first year, getting into the second year, there was a concern I had about the Everglades and these horrific algae blooms that were caused by discharges. You're more familiar with this than me, but I mean, going into the St. Lucie River, the Caloosahatchee on the west coast of Florida, and the devastating effect that had. And I thought, there's got to be a better way. And, you know, kind of came up with the idea from The River of Grass, the book. The only way we're going to be able to protect it, she said, Marjorie Stoneman Douglas, is to buy it. It's in the book. And I'm paraphrasing a little bit, so it's probably not a perfect quote, but close enough. And so I started thinking about that and started, you know, talking with friends that may have an influence on people who had large tracts of land to be able to buy a lot of land south of Lake Okeechobee to try to restore God's plan, pretty good, you know, designer, of the natural flow south that people have pursued. And we eventually were able to come to a place where we signed in a document to do it and started to buy it. And then the economic crash just hit, the Great Recession, which there was nothing great about it, except that it was massive. And so we had to scale back from about 160,000 acres that we wanted to try to preserve to close to 80,000 we ended up with, even in the face of that kind of difficult economy. So I'm very proud we were able to get that kind of start. I'm disappointed that my successor hasn't pursued it, but there'll be a successor to him soon, and maybe we can get back at it again.
You're talking about the U.S. sugar deal is what you're referring to.
I am, yes, sir. Right. Forgive me.
No, that's okay. I just wanted to make sure we're
correct.
On,
we're on
the
same
page.
Yes,
so
sir.
the whose idea was was it you approaching them, or did they approach the government?
It was in concert, you know, and it really doesn't matter. The good thing is it happened. And it may have been initiated here, but really what's important is going forward and making sure that that plan that began, and we got about 50% of it done or thereabouts, that we need to finish the job instead of, you know, having all kind of additional canals. And I mean, the reservoir is not a bad idea, but my God, you know, I mean, the real deal is to do literally, you know, what God created it. We call him the creator. And so, you know, what better way to try to get back to how it's supposed to have been utilized for filtering the water, having the water flow south, than the way God did it in the first place?
Do you take that then to its natural conclusion, which is all of the farming land south of Lake Okeechobee should be bought out and that should be returned to Everglades?
Perhaps, I'm not sure. I mean, I'm a generalist, and like my father, he's a general physician. And so what I think you need to do is have a concept that you believe in, and you've done enough research to realize, not hard here because we're talking about the big guy, so he did it right, but I think you need to take, obviously, the advice of people that have studied the different areas of land, and the ones that are, you know, we got to be efficient. We can't waste taxpayers' money, but make sure that, you know, the land that you do purchase or end up purchasing is the right land, and you do it the right way.
There's disruption as a result. When you buy and take out 80,000 acres or more, one of the things that ends up happening is mills close, people lose their jobs, there's an economic impact to towns such as Clewiston, South Bay, Pahokee, Belglade. What happens to them?
Well, you know, when you do something that this massive and you restore the Everglades to its natural beginning, you make it that much more special to come see. You develop more tourism. You develop additional jobs that happen to be eco-friendly instead of disruptive in the way that it's been for the last 50 years. It got disrupted.
Do you think the farming community has been bad for the Everglades, bad for Florida?
I don't think intentionally, but clearly there are pollutants, there's pesticides. I mean, those aren't good things, you know, for a natural environment to exist, or for the species that exist within that natural environment. It kills stuff. You know, it's killed a lot of stuff. And we've had enough of that. And so I think that what's good for Florida is to go forward and try to get us to a place where you can increase tourism, you can have the Everglades saved, you can have, you know, increased opportunities for employment that are green and friendly. Why not do the right thing? Do the right thing. Spike Lee made a movie about it. Do the right thing.